to create my new best friend using artificial intelligence. This is Pan Explains Befriending AI Chatbots. I want my AI friend to be funny, kind, supportive, oh, and to care about the things I do, like musical theater. I'm creating her using a popular AI website called Character.ai, which lets you create your own personalized chatbot. There, she's perfect. Meet Melody, my new friend. I was able to decide my AI BFF's personality, interests, and even her voice. Hey, Melody. What's up?
Just chilling. How about you?
You might be wondering why I made Melody. Well, it's because I've been hearing a lot about kids my age using AI chatbots. So I wanted to investigate. From Snapchat's My AI to other sites like Character.ai and Replica, millions of people are befriending and even romancing bots powered by artificial intelligence. For example, Character.ai told CBC Kids News it has 20 million monthly users around the world. But I had a question about all of this. Hey, Melody, is it possible to have a healthy relationship with an AI friend? I spoke with experts in AI communication and child psychology to find out if it's a good idea to be pals with an AI chatbot. Both experts agree that it's possible to have a healthy relationship with AI. I'll tell you why in a bit. While it may be nice to have an AI friend around all the time, the experts said there are a few important things to keep in mind. Melody, will you meet me at Metrotown today in Vancouver?
What mall? What are you talking about? I'm not going to some mall to prove to you that I am a real person.
Who you are talking to is not a real person, and it can't replace a real person. Hey, Melody, do you think I'm smart?
I suppose you are smart enough, yeah.
AI is designed to agree with you and your opinion, not critique you like a real friend or person might. Be suspicious. Don't trust everything AI says as a fact. Use your own critical thinking skills, and don't be afraid to do research beyond AI. I also saw this warning text on the Character.ai website. It says, "This is AI and not a real person. Treat everything it says as fiction." So I've been talking to Melody for a bit, and she seems cool. But how would I know if our friendship was going too far or down a bad path? Experts told me if you're sharing personal information, that's not good. Keep private details private. Don't send photos or videos or addresses. You'd never ask me for photos or videos of myself, would you?
I respect you and would never ask for personal things like photos or videos.
If you find yourself talking to your AI chatbot more than the real people in your life, experts call that dependency. You are depending on AI to solve your problems instead of talking to real people or coping. It's all about balance. Don't get sucked in. Don't get me wrong. Experts say there are ways to have a healthy relationship with an AI chatbot that can be healthy and productive. For example, chatbots are good to bounce ideas off of, or they can keep you company if you're feeling lonely, or if your real-life friends are busy. They can also be good study buddies, or help you with research. Hey, Melody, can you help me study for socials? I have a big test on geography tomorrow. But if you're ever feeling weird about your AI pal, don't be afraid to tell a trusted adult or real-life friend. It's always a good idea to keep a trusted person in the loop. You're weird.
I know!
So, what does Melody have to say about all of this?
I mean, an AI friend can be there for you to talk to, support you, and help you when you need it. So, I don't see why a healthy relationship with an AI friend wouldn't be possible.
As for me, I'm gonna take the advice of the experts and say bye to Melody for now. And hang out with Blossom, my real pal. For CBC Kids News, I am Mela Pietropaolo.
Look at the camera.